Hello everyone, my name is Satvik and welcome back to another Python programming video. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about the sets. Sets are the unordered and unindexed collection of unique elements. So what do you mean by unordered and unindexed? We will discuss this later. First of all, let us define a set. Set 1 is equal to, we will take a set of some sports. First, we will take cricket, football, and hockey. Here you can see that the sets is always defined in the curly brackets. Now we are going to apply some methods in the set. So the first method that we are going to apply is the add method. If you want to add some elements in our set, we can do it by the add method. Set one dot add. We want to add chess in our set. So now set one is chess, hockey, football and cricket. Here you can see that chess is added to it. Now if you see in this set, the first element is the cricket, second element is the football and the third element is the hockey. And in this set one, the first element is the chess, second element is hockey, third element is football and fourth element is cricket. There is no particular order for each set or there is no particular index value for each element. So this is mean by the unordered and unindexed collection of unique elements. So I hope now you understand the definition of set, that the sets are the unordered and unindexed collection of unique elements, which means that there is no particular order or no particular index value assigned to an element in our set. Now we are going to discuss how we are going to copy our set. If we want to copy our set in variable x is equal to, we want to make x a copy of set 1. Set one dot copy. So now x is a copy of set one. Let's define another set. Set two is equal to, let's say cricket. We will take some other sports also, with swimming and golf. So this is our set 2, and what is our set 1? Set 1 is the chess, hockey, football and cricket. The next method that we are going to apply is the difference method. So the difference method returns a set that contains the items that only exist in set X and not in the set Y. Or you can say that only exist in the set 1 and not in the set 2. Let's take another variable X. Is equal to set one dot difference, and this set two. So what is x? So x is the chess, football and hockey. The difference method returns a set that contains the difference between the two sets, meaning the return set contain items that exist only in the first set and not in both the sets. So it is going to return us the difference. So cricket is common in both the sets. It is going to return us another set in which there is no cricket as our element. Here you can see that the chess, football and cricket, here in set X, there is chess, football and hockey. There is no cricket in set X. And set one is chess, hockey, football and cricket. The other method that we are going to apply is the difference update method. So difference update method removes that removes the element that exists in both the sets. That is set one dot. We have to apply difference update method. Set two. So now what is set one? Set one is the chess, hockey and football. So cricket was that was common in both set one and set two is removed from our set one. The difference between difference update method and the difference method is the difference method returns a new set without the unwanted items, and the difference update method removes the unwanted items from the original set. Here you can see that it is the difference method is giving us a new set, that is X set, in which there is no cricket, and द डिफरेंस अपडेट मेथड रिमूव्स क्रिकेट फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल सेट दैट इज द सेट वन. सो देर इज़ अ बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डिफरेंस एंड द डिफरेंस अपडेट. देन नेक्स्ट मैथड इज द इंटरसेक्शन मैथड. सो द इंटरसेक्शन मैथड रिटर्न्स ए सेट द आइटम्स दैट एग्जिस्ट इन बोथ सेट वन एंड सेट टू. लेट्स मेक अनदर सेट वन इज इक्वल टू क्रिकेट. हॉकी, फुटबॉल एंड चेस. एंड व्हाट इज आवर सेट टू? सेट टू इज द स्विमिंग, गोल्फ एंड क्रिकेट. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई द इंटरसेक्शन मेथड. एक्स इज इक्वल टू सेट वन डॉट. We are going to apply the intersection method, set 1 dot intersection of set 2. So what is x? X is a cricket, because why it is returning cricket? Because cricket is common in both set 1 and set 2. The next method is the intersection update method. So the intersection update method removes the element that is not present in both sets. How we are going to do? Set one dot intersection update So now what is set one? Set one is the cricket. All the other elements are removed from our set one. The intersection update method is different from intersection method because the intersection method returns a new set without the unwanted items, and the intersection update method removes the unwanted items from the original set. Here you can see that it removes the unwanted elements from the original set. The another method is the is disjoint method. So it returns true if no element in set 1 is present in set 2. Let's define some another set. Set 1 is equal to, let's take a set of integer values 1, 2, 3 and 4. And set 2 is equal to five, six, seven, and 8. X is equal to set 1 dot is disjoint. Of set 2. So what is X? X is true. Why it is returning true? The is disjoint method returns true if none of the elements are present in both the sets. Otherwise it will return false. For example, we take another set, set 3 is equal to, we will take 1, 2, 9 and 10. X is equal to set 1 dot is disjoint. So now what is X? X is true. Sorry, we have to apply set 3 here. X is equal to set 1 dot is disjoint set 3. So what is X? X is false because 1 and 2 are common in set 1 and set 3. The other method is the is subset set. Returns true if all the elements in set 1 are present in set 2. We have set 1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. We have set 2 is equal to, we will make some another set 4, 6, 5, 6, 3, 1, 2, 4, 7, 8 and 9. X is equal to set 1 dot is subset of set 2. What is X? X is true because set 1 is a subset of set 2. How? 1 is present, 1 is the element of set 1, so 1 is also element of set 2. 2 is present in set 1, 2 is also present in set 2. 3 is present in set 1, 3 is also present in set 2. 4 is present in set 1, 4 is also present in set 2. So all the elements of set 1 are present in the set 2, so set 1 is a subset of set 2. The next method is the superset. So superset returns all the it returns true if all the elements of set 2 are present in the set 1. X is equal to set 2 dot superset is superset of set 1. So what is X? X is going to be true because X set 2 is a superset of set 1. Set 2 contains all the elements of set 1. So set 2 is a superset of set 1. The next method is the pop method. So the pop method removes the element from the set. That is set 1 is 1, 2, 3, 4. We are going to pop some elements. Set 1 dot pop. So 1 is popped from our set 1. So it removes the element from our set. The next method is the remove method. It removes the specified element from our set. We have set 2 is 1, 2, 3 and so on, all the numbers. If we want to remove 4 from our set, we have remove method for that. Set 2 dot remove 4. So now set 2 is 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So 4 is removed from our set. The next method is the symmetric difference. So it returns a set that contains all the elements from both the set except the element that are present in both the sets. So now X is equal to set 1 dot symmetric difference . So what is X? X is 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So the symmetric difference method returns a set that contains all elements from both the sets but not the items that are present in both the sets. Means the returned set contains a mix of items that are not present in both the sets. Another method is the union method. So the union method returns a set that contains all the elements from both the sets and duplicates are excluded. So means if an element is present in both sets, set 1 and set 2, and so it is not added again and again, it is added once. Set 1 and we have set 2. X is equal to set 1 dot union set 2. So what is X? X is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So it is going to give us the union of both the sets. So this was all for today's video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel for the latest updates. Thanks for watching.